John?
Yeah, well, let's see. Got a couple stories about Jim. And I met Jim, it was, I think, about 89, and at a men's group. And I was listening to him talk about meditation and all this kind of stuff. I'm a redneck rancher, so this was new to me. And I just had to, after the meeting, I just had to kind of talk to him a little bit about it. So I got a little bit of an insight of what Jim was about and kind of his life. And so he asked me if I'd like to come up and see his place. So as ranchers, you know, we like showing our places off to other ranchers. So I went up to his place and check it out, and it was just, fell in love with the place. Just a very beautiful place, very special place. And so we're starting to talk about dinner, because it was the invite was for come up and see a place and have dinner. And I spent the night, I can't remember for sure that first time I was there, but anyhow, so he says we're going to have salad, and I think we're going to make burritos or something like that. He bought some burritos, and he was going to make this big salad. So, okay, that sounds good. I love salad, but I wasn't really, I didn't know what I was in for when I had a salad with Jim. My salad was, it was iceberg lettuce with Thousand Islands. That was my salad. So anyway, so he had it mostly prepared, and I think the last thing we did, we sliced up some carrots or something, put it in there, but he had it mostly all done. Anyway, so we sit down to eat. We're having the salad first, and I'm eating the salad. My eyes are watering. My throat's burning. And he says, "Boy, how do you like the salad?" I said, "Yeah, it's pretty good. And he goes, "Do you know there are 13 cloves of garlic in this?" I don't know anybody who knows how many cloves of garlic they put in their salad, but Jim knew. So anyway, yeah, I was a meat and potatoes guy, like I said. So the garlic, there was lemon juice, there was Dr. Bonner's, and all that garlic. So anyway, it wasn't my everyday salad. But anyhow, I don't forget that. And another time, Jim wanted to know if I wanted to take a ride with him. So, okay, that's where we're going. Let's see, well, I've got to go to San Francisco. And I got to go to a stockholder meeting, and then I have to go to, I believe it was Santa Cruz, to visit one of the, I'm part owner in a business down there called the Kiva House, I think is what it was. So I'm thinking, once again, redneck rancher. I should have known after the salad what I was in for, but anyway. So we arrived down there, I think it was that day, later that afternoon. And he was telling me it's kind of a sauna and a spa place and this and that. So okay, whatever. So take our gear, we go in there. I figured I'll put on some trunks or whatever, and go get a sauna, go out a sauna, and there was a pool I think too. You could swim. So sound like a lot of fun. So I get my gear. He's got his bag, and go in there and sit down. There's a locker room there. We're sitting down. And Jim strips down, and I'm thinking, well, you got to strip down before you can, you know, put on gear, right? Okay. So I'm thinking, so he strips down, and he stays stripped down. He's sitting there on the bench, and I'm thinking, okay, well, when's he going to put his trunks on? Nothing, just sitting there, and I'm thinking, like, okay, I'm stripped down, almost stripped down at that point, and this guy comes walking by, nude. Something, and he walks right out into the patio, into the place, and I'm thinking, okay. So then Jim says, "Did I tell you it's clothing optional?"
Nope,
you never mentioned that. So
I think I had to.
Jim says, "Well, Well, I'll see you out there. Just then, this gorgeous brunette walks by with nothing on but a birthday suit. And that was when I knew I could pass the test. my first and my last time at that place. But anyway, that was Jim. And I got several more stories. But anyway, you all probably know. You know. Anyway, thanks a lot.